We praise Android for customizability, but you can take it so much further than moving wallpapers or icon themes. And at the same time, you can get rid of the default Android shenanigans. Like, why do I need this stupid thing? What even is that? Okay, so let's talk about the best phone launcher for Android options for that sweet personalized phone feel. All right, I can guarantee you that if you've already searched for phone launcher recommendations, you've encountered the Nova launcher for Android. You can start customizing things as soon as you install it. Icon, search bar, app drawer, it's a very nice initial setup. And then you can just drag stuff around. Some apps have several widgets, so there's a lot of choice too. Nova is constantly pushing out improvements and new features, but I did notice that the app can bug out sometimes. Other than that, Nova is cool and pretty lightweight as well, so it will fit even older devices. Overall, customization is the strongest point of this launcher, especially with the premium plan. It adds stuff like gestures, notification badges, drawer folders, and it's a one-time purchase. That said, the choice between Nova Launcher versus Nova Launcher Prime depends entirely on how much extra stuff you want. But before you jump onto the Nova hype train, there are more best Android phone launcher options, like Smart Launcher. What I absolutely love about this one is that it automatically sorts all my apps into categories. Contacts, internet, games, media, and so on and so forth. Just like with Nova, there's plenty of customization here. You can choose colors and explore an abundance of fonts. Plus, the launcher comes with its very own custom newsfeed. I find it a bit better than what the default Android launcher pushes. Now, there's a pro version as well, which unlocks additional features like advanced adaptive icons, extra home pages, AMOLED black theme, swipe gestures. I could keep going. There's a ton of stuff here. If the first two seem a bit overwhelming, I recommend trying Niagara phone launcher. It's very minimal and clean. You get one main screen where you put your favorite and most used apps. The rest can be found through this alphabet on the side, which you can easily navigate with one hand. So it is great for larger phones. There's a search bar as well, and you can rename the apps to whatever you want. Anything at all. Now, for icon changes and more advanced widgets, you have to get the premium version. There's a yearly subscription with a 7-day free trial, but you can opt for a one-time purchase too. Take that minimalism and turn it up to 100%. You'll get the Minimalist phone launcher. Yes, let's talk about this one. Although it's still in development, I've seen so many ads already. Too many. But hey, if your soul screams for darkness, it's supposed to help you focus and be more mindful. Does it? It takes time to get used to, and you can still mindlessly browse for hours after opening an app, especially if you open the CoolTechZone YouTube channel. I mean, sources say it's great and you should totally subscribe. But as for the minimalist phone, it's okay if you're committed to reducing screen time, but for like $5 a month, sheesh, it's gonna reduce your wallet too. Oh, and another thing, I managed to accidentally block an application with a dedicated feature. Sure, all right, my mistake, but I went to their FAQ page and got this.
Was this article helpful?
No. No, it wasn't. And one more thing. It tracks and then shares a lot of data with third parties, which is just why? If you want a similar minimalist feel without the data tracking, check out O Launcher instead. It's a well-deserved honorable mention. Now, if you say screw minimalism, then AIO Launcher has your back. This bad boy is capable of cramming everything onto your phone screen. Frequently used apps, system information, recently received calls, messages, emails, upcoming calendar events, news, stocks. Ooh, yeah, that is a lot of stuff. And whether you believe it or not, there's even more stuff with premium and premium plus plans. Despite the abundance of everything, the setup is super easy. I just clicked install and everything appeared on the screen right away. And then I was able to customize it to my liking. Pretty neat. Finally, I'd like to dedicate a moment of silence for iPhone users. This about sums it up. So yeah, sorry, no iPhone launcher for you. Yet, at least. I'm hoping that the iOS 18 update will deliver on the promised customization. You can get an Android phone and make it look like an iPhone, though. Find the iOS launcher on Google Play Store and enjoy your fake iPhone. It works fine, I guess. So, what launcher are you using? Share your favorite picks in the comments down below, and we'll see you next time.